I think the rivalry is good. It's been many years that Canada didn't have as many good ladies.
We have the pretty good relationship and we are some good friends.
Cynthia is kind of person that attracts attention the first time you look at her. Joanie has had to sell herself. She can mesmerize you in a very quiet way.
I hope that Cynthia and Joanie for many, many years will trade back and forth the title. I think it's fantastic.
TSN proudly presents coverage of the 2005 BMO Financial Group Canadian Figure Skating Championships. And we're in London, Ontario at the beautiful brand new John Labatt Center, a building that's just a little over 2 years old. It's a great building and we're expecting some great skating here this week. Hi everybody, I'm Dave Randorf and welcome to one of the truly special events on the Canadian sporting calendar, the Nationals. Some teams or some skaters from coast to coast just living out a dream, making it this far. Others looking to take it to the next step and make it to the national team that will go to the Worlds in Moscow later this spring. A year ago, we were in Edmonton, and what a week that was. There were great stories everywhere you looked. How about 25-year-old Ben Ferreira landing his first clean quads in competition? He lit up the rink and finished a career best second, which was good, but in the end, not good enough. This guy was simply better than the rest. Emmanuel Sandu won his second of back-to-back titles, his third of his career, and he'll look to extend that streak here this week in London. There were some surprises as well, like in the pairs competition. Valerie Marcoux and Craig Bunton, in just their second senior nationals together as a team, they went out and won it. No one was more surprised than Valerie and Craig to be national champions. But the biggest surprise, no question about it, was this young lady right here, 16 years old at the time, Cynthia Phuneuf. In the ladies' competition, ended the five-year reign of Jennifer Robinson and set up what is truly now a great rivalry in women's skating. Joanie Rochette finished second, and those two will be in the spotlight here all this week, beginning tonight with the ladies' short program. For more on that and to help set up our 3 hours of primetime coverage tonight on TSN, here are Rod Black and Tracy Wilson.
Thank you, Dave, and hi, everybody. And yes, stand by for excitement and some surprises this week. The national championships, as Dave mentioned, lead to placement at the Worlds. The Worlds lead to placement at the Olympics. So what happens here this week in London could have a lot to do with what happens next year in Torino.
It's very important that Canada sends a very strong team to the World Championships to earn spots for the Olympic teams. And all I can say is, so far, so good for Team Canada. The national team had its best season ever on the Grand Prix circuit, winning 13 medals and culminating with two men skating in the Grand Prix final for the first time from Canada. But even more surprisingly, two ladies qualified and skated in the Grand Prix final for Canada.
Joanie Rochette, who finished third a month ago in Beijing, and Cynthia Phuneuf, the defending Canadian champion, who finished sixth out of six, did not have a great performance, but both skaters say that performance, that competition is behind them, and now they share the spotlight this week in London. The friends turned rivals, sharing the top billing at the Nationals.
For sure, it's a little bit more stress, and I said that it's different, but so you're first, and you know that all the attention is on you.
I'm feeling good. Of course, we always have little injuries everywhere, but this week I'm feeling really good and very confident going into this competition.
Rivalries are great for skating. For women in Canada, it's been a long, dry spell that there's even been one woman, let alone two really good women, who could either win and represent Canada, you know, at the very top level.
We try to always keep her in the present moment because she's very intense, so make sure she stays calm and in her bubble and in her zone, you know. That's our main goal every time she steps on the ice.
Today was good. I'm just adjusting to new ice, and I mean, jumps were good in general. Of course, I just popped some loops today, but it's very unusual. Usually, the loop is not a jump that I will miss often.
She did a few mistakes, but she fixed everything and she felt good about herself. At the end, she was happy and she felt good. She's ready to go for tomorrow.
Since the Grand Prix final, we've just been working on having more speed and more flexibility and trying to forget about what happened there in the short program.
I just want to go at the wall. That's my first goal, and I just want to skate well to go there. I had some difficulty with my triple tip, but I know what is wrong, so I'm going to fix it for tomorrow.
I think practice was better than yesterday because she was more focused. She has less stress, so I think she was better.
The warm-up was great. She didn't even come to see us because we told her what she needed to do. So we just let her go and try not to be in the way. And if she needs us, we're there. So that's simple.
The qualifying, you need to take this more as a practice. It's the first competition of the week and it's very early. So just trying to be comfortable and get one more run through done before the competition starts.
She did a really nice combination at the beginning. She sort of hesitated a little bit for the second triple, which I think is fine because she did it many times in practice. She knows she can do it.
I was supposed to do triple-triple-double. After qualifying, you forget about it and get ready for the short. That's more important.
On the warm-up, it was a little bit rough. She was like on and off at the beginning. The first 2 minutes, I thought she was not over her feet.
I was a little bit more stressed than other person in qualifying because in China I skate so bad and I was just afraid about what can happen here and I was a little bit more stressed about that.
She was not like happy with that performance, but she felt relieved. We just preferred a little bit from last year because for the qualifying last year it wasn't good, so we referred to last year and we said, you know, it's better than last year, so we're on the good track, just let's keep going.
So after qualifying, Cynthia and Joanny both won their pools, but this is the new scoring system, so you carry your points over. Joanny Rochette leading Cynthia Phaneuf, and everything is factored. But is this rivalry the second coming of the Kurt and Elvis rivalry that we had in the men's ranks?
It definitely has that potential, Rod. We're talking about two teenagers here, 17 and 19 years of age, with tons of potential. So definitely, I think everybody here is expecting this as a rivalry and hoping that can continue for many years.
And here's what they've done since last year at the Nationals. Mentioned the bronze medal that Joanny won at the Grand Prix final, Cynthia finishing sixth. But look what she did. Cynthia Phaneuf had a great start to the season, winning Skate Canada after the second at Skate America.
And you have to remember, that is her first time out on the Grand Prix circuit, so quite remarkable. Joanny Rochette winning a bronze medal at the Grand Prix final. Kwan and Cohen, the American skaters, were not there. However, Joanny Rochette has been given credit a couple of times this year for landing a triple-triple in combination. She's developing the arsenal to compete with the very best in the world.
The women's short program coming up next from London at the Nationals.
Final triple, triple toe, double toe.
She has made a name for herself this week. And she might be going to the World Championships. Unbelievable. Cynthia Phaneuf, Canada's new champion. Well, that was a year ago in Edmonton, Cynthia Phaneuf. Her coronation as Canadian champion. Welcome to a snowy London, Ontario, the Labatt Center, home to the 2005 Nationals. Earlier this week, this was Cynthia Phaneuf. On Monday, the qualifier, she was in qualifying group A.
She won that qualifying group. The one jump, though, that gave her a real tough time was the triple flip. She'll be hoping to nail that tonight. In second place in qualifier A, Leslie Hawker, who skates in Barrie, Ontario. She had a bouncy performance, skated very well in the qualifying round. So she was second behind Cynthia Phaneuf.
And here is Amanda Billings from Calgary.
third in her qualifying group.
And what a bright future this skater has. She's been injured, has struggled in the summer, but it's coming together for her, and it did in the qualifying.
And over on the other qualifying section, Joanie Rochette leading the way and expected to be one of the co-favorites here this week.
A smooth yet athletic performance, and where Cynthia Phaneuf struggled with her flip, Joanie struggled with her lutz in the qualifying.
Here's young Mira Leung, 15-year-old.
She didn't struggle with anything.
She ripped off triples left and right.
Hot on the heels of the top two, Cynthia and Joanie.
And last year's junior champion, Marianne Sampson, who did not go to the Junior World Championships because Cynthia Phaneuf ended up going to the Junior Worlds and not the Worlds. But remember, last year, under the old system, you basically had placements heading towards the short program. Now the points carry over. They divided the points by four, and those are the totals right now. So Joanie Rochette has, in fact, a four-point lead over Cynthia Phaneuf. And already we've had some skaters on the ice here tonight. Earlier, this was Mylène Brodeur from Quebec.
At this point in the competition, Mylène is sitting in first place, and you can see quite delighted by her short program skate. Second place at this point in the competition, Courtney Sokol from Alberta, and she's coached by Michael Klipchuk, the 1992 Canadian men's champion. Beautiful triple flip there that Courtney was very happy with.
And then the local favorite, the hometown favorite, Lauren Wilson, who is in third place right now. She had a difficult qualifier. Barely made it into the main draw. She did, and she looked pretty happy after her short program earlier tonight. So here are the standings of the skaters who have already skated their short program. Mylène Brodeur, Courtney Sokol, and again, there's the total combined with the qualifying total from earlier. Mylène Brodeur's short program, the best of the bunch, 38.49, and some of the other skaters who have already skated, and we have a number of skaters to come. Welcome inside final moments of this warm-up. We will see Joanie Rochette and Cynthia Phaneuf in the final flight. Ashton Tessier, one of the skaters in this group. So we get a chance to see a lot of skaters we haven't seen before at the Nationals, and they get some prime time play here tonight in London.
Now, for the qualifying round, the skaters competed with their free program. Tonight, it's the short program with required elements. You can see there are eight. The skaters have to include those exact elements, or there are severe deductions. And they cannot add jumps to make up extra points. So this is a very stressful part of the competition for the ladies.
Again, under the new scoring system, it is basically a system of addition. Before, it was more about deductions. At the U.S. Nationals last week, they used the old system, 6.0, but now everybody's gone to the new system, and we'll talk certainly more about it as the night and the week progresses. Beginning this second last flight from the Mariposa Club in Barrie, Ontario, Ashton Tessier. She was fifth in her qualifying group. Her total was 16.62.
Ashton will skate to Dance Mediterranean. 11th in juniors last year. She's trying to now make it at the senior level. Only 18, so she can earn herself a spot on the Junior Grand Prix team. Opening with a triple lutz. Oh, slightly tilted in the air. She's got another difficult jump coming up. A very nice triple loop. Very common at this level when a skater misses early on. It unnerves them for the rest of the program. They haven't developed the experience to fight back. Back in 2003, Ashlyn was one of the favorites to win the Junior Canadians. She had to withdraw due to injury. Last year, she was favored once again, was second in the short, came apart in the long, ended up finishing 11th overall. Opening up on a much-needed double axel.
From the Ottawa area, Ashton Tessier.
Ashton Tessier.
Her short program will have the marks. Reintroduce you to the new scoring system in a moment on TSN. 18-year-old Ashton Tessier, along with Coach Doug Lee, his wife, choreographer Michelle Lee, of course, the Skating Factory in Barrie, Ontario. The Mariposa Club.
Well, they're discussing her performance. Here are the Lutz tilted in the air, and the edge just slipped off on the ice. No chance. I really like the way, though, she got herself back together. Beautiful triple loop, fighting for the landing. And they were discussing the double axel, an easy jump for Ashton at the end of the program. And her coach, Doug, said it was in the right place. You had the right speed, and it was one of those, you ask yourself what happened mentally. Just let it get away from her at the end of the performance.
This, of course, has always been known as the kiss and cry area. It's now called the calculate area. You gotta do your math here. You gotta watch the numbers, and it is the cumulative points calculation system. Canada, Skate Canada, huge proponent, builder of this system, very computerized, but also the keen eye of the judges. And we will have a technical score, an element score, plus the program component score. And here's a look, Tracy, what they look at.
So the judges there, those are the component marks that they will enter, and that's for the various aspects of the performance, like the choreography, the interpretation, the skating skills. And of course, the judges will also score the jumps. And so, for instance, that double axel that Ashton missed at the end of the performance, if she had landed it, would have been at least 3.3. The fall, or the miss on it, the open up on it, drops it to a 0.3. So 3 points right there she loses. And that's kind of how they go about the technical element marks here. Those are for the jumps and the spins, the required elements. The program components next for all the other aspects of the performance. A deduction there, a mandatory 1 point deduction for a fall. And then you see the overall total.
Ashton Tessier is currently in sixth place. Thank you.
Final moments with coach.
Represents Western Ontario, Aaron Shearer.
Here is Aaron Shearer. Last year was third in the juniors. We're going to see a few of those junior eligible skaters who have made the jump to the senior ranks. It is never easy.
Not easy at all, but this skater has shown us that she is very, very tough. Last year at juniors, after the short program, She stabbed herself. The blade of one skate went right through her boot. Skated with an injured foot in the free program, was able to hang on and win the bronze medal, performing a tango here called Jalouse. Double-toe combination, well performed, not the high degree of difficulty of the triple lutz, which you'll see most of the top competitors executing. It's a smart move to play it safe in the short program. Do what you do best. Here's a triple loop coming up. Almost. Of Olympic champion Sarah Hughes, gets her programs choreographed. She's a very strong, powerful skater, only 16 years of age. Oh, high, beautiful double axel.
Erin Scherer at the Nationals. First short program. You're watching the BMO Financial Group Canadian Skating Championships on TSN. Well, not too far from here, warming up at the Western Fair. Annabelle Langlois, Patrice Arquette, they get ready for their short program tonight. And there are the defending Canadian pairs champions, Valerie Marcoux and Craig Bunton. They'll make the trip over here and skate later tonight here on TSN. And also, another young lady who will be skating in pairs is actually on the ice now. This is her warm-up, Megan DeHamel, who will skate with partner Ryan Arnold a little later, and now will skate her short program. She was the junior champion of Canada back in 2003.
She had a win on the Junior Grand Prix circuit this season in France and finished fifth in the Junior Grand Prix final. Too much height.
Had her tiptoe the landing.
Oh, very nice triple flip. I love her power and her speed into of the jumps, makes it very exciting to watch. Reminds me of Elizabeth Manley.
All this from a skater who has a bit of a wonky left ankle.
She was pushing through the pain in her ankle this year. She didn't want to stop skating, was on such a roll, but they did some x-rays and found a stress fracture, so she's had to severely limit her training time. There's two spots on the junior world team, and Megan wants to be one of them. Again, height and speed on the landing on that double axel. Much better than her performance in the qualifying round. She came in here with huge expectations. Many mistakes in the Q round, a much better effort here.
Her goal is to try to get to the Junior World Championships, make that team just down the road in Kitchener in late February. Megan's marks after this, everybody. Pride of lively Ontario, 19-year-old Megan Duhamel came back from Helsinki recently at the Junior Grand Prix Final. Again, still with that stress fracture in her ankle, finished fifth at the Junior Grand Prix Final. Big step for her.
Well, before the injury, she skated lights out in France, nailing this jump, her triple lutz. And, you know, not a huge mistake, but a huge jump. It looked like she got so high. Watch her spring, but she's tilted a little bit forward. Digs in with her toe pick and then just has to touch down with her hand. So she will get a deduction on the grade of execution, the quality of the landing of that jump. I just think she's so exciting to watch. Now, in France, her mark was a 54. She won't get that here, but that was the third highest by a Canadian lady this year in competition. Her average is a 44, so she's beaten her average. Not a bad skate.
Yeah, ranking first, and again, her goal to get to the World Junior Championship in Kitchener in about a month.
Thank you. Notre prochaine participante, our next competitor, du Québec, Vicky Poisson.
Backstage, defending champion, getting ready. On ice, Vicky Boissonneau and her short program from Lebec, Quebec. She was sixth in her qualifier.
Vicky finished eighth at the Canadian Championships last year. Her goal is to make the top six. That'll help. Triple lutz, double toe, slight touchdown though on the first jump. Vicky did not hold back in that performance. She skated with a lot of speed, but a few too many mistakes to crack the top six in this short program.
You're watching the BMO Financial Group Canadian Skating Championships on TSN. Great expectations hovering over Joanie Rochette, 19-year-old, coming off a third-place finish at the Grand Prix Final in Beijing.
I was born in Montreal, but raised in Île-du-Pas, Quebec. Île-du-Pas is a little island situated between Berthierville and Sorel. It's in the middle of the St. Lawrence River. I lived there until I was 12 years old, and then I moved to Trois-Rivières for training for my skating. My dad coached hockey a little bit, and so he brought me to skate when I was very young. But I really started to skate when I was 6 years old. My mom took me to a free session of skating for tryouts, and I fell in love with it. I really liked it the first time. I was a very active child. I think I was driving my mom crazy sometimes. I couldn't stand still for more than 5 minutes. I would always be the first one on the ice and the last one to leave because I would only want to do one more. Or I would ask the Zamboni guy to wait a little bit and watch me skate, or watch one more, I'm gonna land it this time. Or through my careers, I had many ups and downs. 1 year when I was 12 years old, my first year of high school, I almost quit skating because I couldn't find any motivation anymore. So I sat down with my parents and decided that it was better for me to change coach and move to Trois-Rivières with Mano. So this was a very defining moment in my career. Mano recognized the good things I could do when I was down, and she took me and she put me back on track. She not only had the role of a coach, but also a mother. The relationship between me and Mano came to an end because of a very disastrous skate in a Quebec competition. My skating was okay, but not what it should be, and I was missing all the motivation I needed to go further. And Mano called me, and she said it was over, and that I needed to find someone else to coach me. José and Sebastian brought out a lot of new things in me. José is a very calm person, and she can help me whenever I get tense or stressed out. And Sebastian is an artist on and off the ice, so I feel a lot more confident now in my skating. I've grown up. It's all about maturity, I think, now.
Well, inspiration certainly coming from many areas for Joanie Rochette, new coaches. There's Michael Slipchuk, a former Canadian champion, and her old coach watching as well. You see that happen a lot. Skaters will go through coaches.
But Manon Perron, you have to give her credit for developing a fine athlete. Joanie credits her with her work ethic and her great technique, but also facilitating the change that she felt was better for Joanie the skater. Even though professionally it's not great for Manon to pass off a skater at this level, but it was Manon's decision. She felt that was truly what was best for her skater. And you can see her quietly encouraging Joanie in the background and in the hallways at the rink.
Well, could she become the next Canadian champion, or will Cynthia Phaneuf make it two in a row? Again, the surprise winner a year ago in Edmonton, ending the dynasty of Dave Randorf's guest, Jennifer Robinson, who happens to be the honorary chair here this week. Dave.
Yeah, this is the most relaxed Jennifer's been prior to a skate in, what, 13 years?
Yeah, roughly 13 years, and is definitely, without a doubt, the most relaxed I've ever been.
Well, a lot of people miss you out there, but it's nice to see you back at the Canadians as the honorary chairperson. I want to ask you, you won your first title in 1996, and then found it difficult to defend. It was a couple more years before you put together that run. Tell us about what Cynthia is going through as the defending champ.
Well, it's very tough to come into your Canadian Championships as defending champion. You need to draw on a lot of strength, rely on your training and that trust that you know you can do those elements when it counts. She has a lot of experience having gone to Junior Worlds and doing so well as Skate Canada champion, and she needs to draw on that strength right now to get her through this first Canadian Championship as defending champion.
Yeah, it's a tough road to hoe, but thanks for your insight, and we'll let you get back up into the seats and relax and enjoy.
I'm going to. Thank you.
Thanks, Jen.
So Cynthia Phaneuf continuing her warm-up. There has been a lot of hype placed on Cynthia Phaneuf and Joanny Rochette. They have competed at the Grand Prix Final. There are a lot of other skaters out there. Is this hype at this time deserved, do you think? Or is there too much hype around these two?
Well, I mean, too much hype is going to put more pressure on them, but they're great skaters. They are turning heads artistically because of their beautiful programs and their interpretation, but they're also putting the goods in technically. They are landing the triple jumps, so, you know, the hype is deserved. They've got it. It's can they do it time and time again? Do they have hearts of competitors?
Remember last year, though, a lot of people thought that maybe that national championship, a lot of people would wilt in the spotlight. They did not, and we had a terrific skate from most of the female competitors. Here we are, final flight now in this short program. Here is Marianne Sampson, who will start it off. Mireille Young, then Cynthia Phaneuf, Leslie Hawker, Joanny Rochette, and then Amanda Billings.
And what a meteoric rise this skater has had over the last couple of years. In 2003, she was second in pre-novice. That's three levels down. Won juniors last year, now the final flight of seniors, and she's only 16. Double axel to open. Now for her combination, triple lutz, double loop plant. A slight deduction for the space between the jumps. Nice triple lutz though, nice double loop. Triple salchow, didn't fully rotate it. We'll see if she's going to be given credit for a triple or a double. She missed 4 months of training this summer with tendonitis in the right knee. She has rather modest goals at the Canadian Championship. She told me, she says, I just want to look like I belong in seniors. Well, she certainly does.
Yes, indeed. Oh, no. You know, you see that a lot with some of the younger skaters making the leap up to the senior ranks. Those final 30 seconds, sometimes, whether it's a brain cramp or whatever, a mistake in the stretch for Marianne Sampson, Canada's reigning junior champion, first trip to the senior nationals. 16-year-old from Lacadie, Quebec, Marianne Sampson, who did not go to the Junior Worlds last year. Her spot was filled by Cynthia Phaneuf, remember. But she had a pretty good first start here in the short program at a senior level.
Well, let's take a look at the landing there of her triple lutz. And she just had an extra turn, which turned that into a sequence. Judges looking for the landing of one to be the takeoff of the second jump, and that was a very costly mistake. Under-rotated, so the triple salchow, which would have been a 4.5, goes down to a 1.3 with the double, and then deductions on top of that for the mistake in the short program, because you have to do a triple. And then a mental error at the end, as you said, Rod, she's thinking about the program. And while she's lowered her expectations because of the injury, she would dearly like to earn one of the two spots to Junior Worlds.
She can fly, though. Very quick out there. 33.65 overall total, 52.17. From Marianne Sampson, who is in sixth place.
And this is a skater to watch in the future because of her speed and power and high jumps. Mira Leon.
Leader right now, Megan DeHamel. And on the ice, the 15-year-old Mira Leung electrified the crowd the other day in the qualifier. Hails from Vancouver, finished fifth at the Nationals a year ago.
Mira rarely falls. If she makes a mistake on her jumps, it's because she under-rotates them. Watch the landing. Oh, no mistake there. Good height on the triple flip, clean landing. A slight turn before the double loop. Small deduction, nice triple lutz. On the approach to her jumps, and that will be taken into consideration by the judges. They like to see the speed on the takeoff and the landing. Consistent jumper, and this is the area she's been working to improve, her footwork and expression and the speed within the elements.
The qualifier, though, the crowd loves her. What's not to love? Mira Leung fighting in that mini battle for the Junior Worlds spots. But she could be a dark horse here.
Hey, she's only 1 point behind Phaneuf coming into this short program.
Cynthia's next. With Coach Joanne McLeod, who also coaches Emmanuel Sandu, Mira Leung. Again, we talked about the two spots available to the World Championships for the women here. There are also two spots available for the Junior World Championships. And Mira, of course, is age eligible, but she just might configure into the top two at the senior rank.
If I know Mira, she's got her sights set on senior world. She's that kind of competitor, showing her flexibility, and she's really worked on her artistry. You can see the improvement over just Skate Canada, which was a few months ago, and that's an area that needed to be addressed, and is still lacking slightly if you are to compare her with Phaneuf and Joanie Rochette. She doesn't quite have the speed and the artistry, but she's a machine when it comes to the jumps. And, you know, she's...
It's her landings.
She's been working on a triple-triple combination. She says, I can do it most of the time. I said, well, how often do you need to do it before you'll put it into the competition? She looked at me, she says, 99.9% of the time. She does not want to go out and make mistakes.
No fear. No fear at all. And, you know, a lot of people think, well, 2010 in her hometown, the Winter Olympics, she says, forget 2010, I like to be at the 2006 games. Cynthia Phaneuf getting ready, the defending women's champion. And again, right now, she carries her points over from the qualifier, currently in second place. Mira is carrying over 22.21 points. And our leader right now, again, is Megan Duhamel.
Well, if you're to look at best short programs, best short program for Cynthia Phaneuf in terms of points, 57.76. For Mira Leung, it's 44.78. So keep that in mind. If she can do anything better than 45, that's great for her in this short program.
Have a calculator around to make sure you got all the numbers. As they wait for the marks, and Cynthia with Coach Annie Barabé, let's get Dave Randorf in here. Dave.
Well, just watching the individual approaches for Joanie Rochette and Cynthia Phaneuf before they take to the ice. Joanie chose to isolate herself with her coach, Jose Normand, in a dressing room. While Cynthia, I watched her take her skates off and do a couple of floor run-throughs. She had a couple of brief conversations with her choreographer, David Wilson, and she appears loose and smiling down here at the boards.
I find kind of funky is the fact that Cynthia and Joanie share the same choreographer.
Well, a lot of people share David Wilson, and he has five of the top men in Canada, and he has done so much for the sport. Incredibly talented. He's choreographer of Jeffrey Buttle, of Ben Ferreira, Sean Sawyer, and it goes on, and has, of course, have worked with Joanie and Cynthia. Cynthia, since she was 9 years old. Choreography now even more important than it ever was with the new system. This delay here is because the technical specialist goes over every element, and they will be checking to see the landings of the jumps, the takeoffs, just to make sure that they are assessing them correctly. They have the slow motion replay. Unfortunately, though, it does slow down the competition somewhat sometimes.
There are a lot of people who have talked about this system. There is some talk again about, you know, because it's so new and some of the anonymity that goes with judges, certainly at an international competition, but for the most part, it has received rave reviews. The skaters are starting to get used to it. Leslie Hawker backstage warming up. But a lot of the skaters are now thinking more before the skate about what they put in to get the most points out of this system.
I'm watching Cynthia Phaneuf on the ice right now, and this has taken her out of her usual preparation. The skater has an idea. It's just a sense of how much time you have, and you get yourself ready to go, and she keeps having to come back. But you know what? Hey, it's part of the game. And the trick is to be able to be ready for anything.
So a delay from the marks, the judges, and the computer, but here it is now, the set of marks.
The total marks for
41.35, just shy of her best so far. Crowd doesn't like it. She's currently in second place. So I said the judging system has met with rave reviews, but maybe not from this crowd in London here tonight. They thought Mira Leung deserved better. She is really a half point shy of Megan Duhamel. And finally, Cynthia Phaneuf. And again, this can rattle you a little bit. Here comes the defending women's champion of Canada. Just turned 17 on Sunday. Began the season with a bang, a second place, a first place. Has had a little bit of a low ebb coming into this.
At the Grand Prix final, Cynthia said she experienced fear for the first time. She said she had no control over her skating. and was very happy with her performance in the qualifying round, but definitely wants to build from that performance.
Stayed on her feet, but it was shaky.
Shaky, and her most difficult jump is coming up. Here it comes. She missed it in the qualifying. Triple flip. Oh, what a fighter.
She panicked in Beijing, the Grand Prix final in the short program. Shaky start, but no panic after that. Skated like a champ. Cynthia Phaneuf with Joanny Rochette still ahead in London at the Nationals.
Well, Cynthia Phaneuf wanted to get one step better than the qualifying rounds, and she certainly did that in the short program. Look at the speed she's carrying into this triple lutz. She gets good height, but just steps out on the landing. So the base mark for that jump is 7.3. She'll lose some marks with quality. That is the key jump, the triple flip. She was popping it in the short program and in practice, in the free skate and in practices. But came back fighting, especially after the shaky start, and that's what you want to see, somebody who can recover. The choreography throughout this program is intricate, it's refined, beautifully presented.
How much has
high
her
marks
life,
for that.
How much has her life changed in the last year? Winning and then choosing not to go to the World Championships, having a great start to the season. She will be the leader, no doubt. And the marks, not a personal best so far under this new scoring system, but that's the number to beat. 78.18, Cynthia Phaneuf, leader by a long shot right now. So Phaneuf, 78.18. Megan DeHamel, 64.26. A big valley between 1 and 2. And now Leslie Hawker's turn. Here is someone who seems to pick her game up when the Nationals come around. She has had some of the best moments of her skating career. at the Canadian Championships, hasn't she?
Yes, she has, and she's come to the sport relatively late. She's 23 years of age, and this was her first year on the national team. She's the oldest of 10. She lives and trains in Barrie, and everything she's earned, she's just got from hard work and spirit. Wonderful competitor. Fall there on her triple lutz. Again, the most difficult jump is the jump that comes after a fall. Here comes her triple flip. Tilted in the air. Leslie's fighting for a medal at this competition. She can't make any more mistakes in the short program. Here's her double axel.
Tough start, good finish for Leslie Hawker. Two skaters to come, including Joanie Rochette, the bronze medalist from the Grand Prix final, is up next in London on TSN. Leslie Hawker talking with her coaches from the Mariposa Club. A year ago, sixth, the year before ninth. She is continuing to make steady improvement in this sport.
You know, the mistake for any jump comes usually on the takeoff, and it's because the upper body starts to spin too soon and you don't rotate in the air as a unit. And that's what happened on Leslie's first jump, and it started to go on her second jump, but she was able to hold it together. And you can see she was really fighting through this program. I don't think she was entirely comfortable. Some of her spins were off center. So I think she did a very good job of getting the most out of herself in that program.
Carrying over 21.88. Her best short program this year, 46.36. 2 points shy of that. Her overall is 66. Leslie Hawker is in second place. The worst she will be heading to the free skate is fourth. Good for her. Cynthia Phaneuf leads. And now Joanie Rochette's turn. Score to beat 78.18. Joanie needs a 50.83 or better. And you would have to say If our old friend Mo was with any skater heading into this, and I speak of momentum, it would be with Joanie Rochette. She comes in here riding a streak, and especially after the Grand Prix final where she won a bronze medal.
Skating to Dunkey Trio. She will open with one of her easier jumps, double axel. Final jump, and she's home free. Triple flip.
Final 30 seconds. If not for that slip, Tracy, in the corner, that was almost perfect.
Presentation.
She'll be the leader. Wants to become a Canadian champion, and like her friend Cynthia Phaneuf, has eyes on a bigger prize someday to make the world podium. Women's skating in Canada, better than it has been in a long, long time. And one of the great young skaters in Canada, Joanie Rochette.
Watch the speed and the height. A very secure jump, a little forward on the landing of the first, but she has the power and the know-how to easily do the second, the double toe. Look at her program. The choreography is quite intricate and a little bit sloppy there, but that was the only letdown in an otherwise stunning performance.
Her best short program was 55.68 at the Grand Prix final. That's the best she's done so far. She has a huge lead here. Joanie Rochette. And I'll tell you what, her old coach is also very proud of her. Vinon Perron watching. Cynthia Phaneuf, as she wants to retain her crown, will have to make up almost 10 points. Not unheard of. 10 points in the free skate. One skater left here, drawn to skate last in this final flight in the women's short program, Amanda Billings from Calgary. 18-year-old who was ninth at the Nationals a year ago. Wants to put herself in good stead heading into the free skate tomorrow night.
Well, this is a skater with all the goods. She reminds me of a young Ekaterina Gordieva, the great Russian pair skater. What she is lacking is competition experience, particularly this year because she was injured, lacks a little bit of confidence, so she's in a tough place to skate after Joanny Rochette. Skating to Conga. That'll do. You can see the height. It's a fine jumper. However, a new jump for her this year in competition is a triple flip. It's coming up. It's the next jump. And she's changed it. She changed it to a salchow. It had to be a triple. She doubled it. Big mistake. Amanda over and over again. She is a delightful skater with all the fine qualities. Trouble on the jumps today, though. We'll see just how costly in a moment.
Calgary's Amanda Billings, just one big glitch really in her program. Sharon LaRiviere is her coach. That's Scott Davis, two-time American champion, who helps her out with some choreography, is also a technical specialist. Loved watching Scott Davis skate a few years ago.
And he's really helped Amanda with her jumping technique. She had good speed at the start of her program. This was going to be a triple flip. Then she changed it to a double salchow, made that decision earlier on the warm-up. But when you double a triple jump, it's a big, big deduction, as this has required elements. Amanda, I think, just needs to get out into the international scene and get seen. She's a beautiful skater and has to just get the experience to know what it feels like to skate after a skater like Joanny Rochette and to be able to get out there and compete when the going gets tough.
Very interesting battle brewing tomorrow night for the top two spots, which you would have to think Joanny Rochette and Cynthia Phaneuf are the favorites for, and then the podium, and then another battle for the junior world spots. Mira Leung is just ahead of Amanda Billings. Megan DeHamel is just ahead of Mira. So that is going to be fun to watch. Here are some of the other skaters, along with their provincial flag, many of them who skated earlier tonight. Many of them, their goal is just to get to the national championships. They don't think about medals, just getting here and getting seen, as you mentioned, and being around better skaters. It makes them better. in the long run, and maybe someday they could be as good as Joanie Rochette. Wasn't that something here tonight? Here's Dave Randor.
Certainly was, with Joanie Rochette, the leader. A year ago, the short program was not kind to you, but tonight, pretty well flawless. Tell us how you felt this evening.
I'm very happy with the job I've done tonight. I didn't feel so comfortable in my blade. I think it showed a bit at the end of the footwork, where I had a kind of a wobble. But overall, I'm very happy with this performance.
Joanie, we've been talking about this this young rivalry developing between you and Cynthia, but it's a friendly rivalry from what we understand. Tell us about your relationship with your friend Cynthia.
Yes, we've known each other for a long time, and off the ice we get along very well, and on the ice we're very competitive, both of us, and I think this is helping each other to improve and giving motivation for the next competition.
You go to sleep now as the leader. Hope you get some rest, and we'll see you tomorrow night.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. We'll be back to London at the BMO Canadian Figure Skating Championships right after this.
Welcome back, everybody. Still to come, the pairs short program here in London tonight, but let's talk about the women's event. No denying Joanie Rochette's performance. Big lead over Cynthia Phaneuf. What happened with Mira Leung? I know maybe her friends or family might wonder why she was deducted so heavily.
Well, I think everybody was wondering and why there was such a hold up with her marks. And what happened was they discounted and did not give Mira credit for her final spin. So one of her eight elements was not allowed because she recentered the spin. And it is quite technical, but at the end of it all, she missed an element. And so that's kind of what's hurt her.
Can Joanie Rochette just put the sails up now? Does she play safe? It's a big lead, 10 points.
You know, you talked about momentum and the momentum that's building for her. She'll want to keep that going, and also her confidence is building. It's quite scary because you're wondering how good can this skater become. For Cynthia Phaneuf, it's all about just taking it up a notch now from the short program. And she said, you know, I realized at the Grand Prix final that fear is any athlete's greatest enemy, and that's a huge obstacle to overcome, and she's slowly doing that. You know, it's going to be very difficult for her to catch Joanie, but it's not over till it's over, as you know.
Yeah, 1-2 punch internationally in women's skating, and we'll see it in the men tomorrow night. Two skaters who have done very well internationally as well. The battle between Buttle and Emmanuel Sandu tomorrow night here in London.
The men's event's fascinating because Emmanuel is a three-time Canadian champion and Jeff has never beaten him at a Canadian championship. But Jeff beat him last month in the Grand Prix final, which is in the big leagues, and he did it under the new judging system, which is the judging system that they're using here.
What I'm thinking about at this competition is myself. And what I'm also thinking about is the fact that I have two quads that I'm going to be trying here.
The plan with quads for this week is really just to leave it out. I mean, I'm going to be working on it on practices and whatnot, but I think really the bigger plan is just to put down a good performance here, qualify myself for the World Championships, and then have it ready for the World. I think that's the smartest thing to do.
But there is an intense rivalry, and you watch these skaters on practice, and you know they're aware of their competitors, they're aware of what they're doing. And, you know, don't count out Ben Ferreira.
Yeah.
He's another player who could come into the mix. What these guys have to do is they have to go out and stop thinking and go out and skate like they can, put on a show.
Yeah, the men's field still very, very deep, but certainly Emmanuel Sandu and Jeff Buttle, they'll be front and center tomorrow.